Hello, hello, DCS Spitfire, Burning Skies server, and I'm just getting my aircraft set for takeoff, for start. Near another aircraft nearby, also doing the same, very low RPM. Dude, 5 pumps. Oh, but they also start our engine. Okay. Taxi out before we collide with a load of other Spitfires all doing the same thing. Okay, the first one's lined up to go. That rolling. Okay, so that's the throttle. The track in the elevator. And up we go. Another one just getting airborne behind me. Right, we close the canopy. And we start climbing towards the enemy, but not directly, because I want to take my time just a little bit here. Okay, I'm gonna climb now in this direction up the coast. And I'm climbing on 2700 RPM and about 10 pounds of boost pressure. There's a Spitfire off my right wing, there's two getting airborne, and there's the early starter over there who is well on his way. I'm trying to stay balanced in the climb and just powering our way forward. The enemy will be above us when we meet them. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to turn back across the tail of this other Spitfire here. Okay, he's not letting me go past this tail. He wants to... stay formed. I'm going to follow the lead Spitfire up. A bit more RPM now. Lead Spitfire directly out in front of me. This guy's staying off my left wing. ,000 feet still climbing. Okay, the lead aircraft has actually moved out to the left a bit. Taking a longer route to the target than I expected. Like the enemy base is basically beelining it for, but maybe he's going to try and protect his ships here. He'll certainly see the enemy first. Okay, I've got contact already at my 2 o'clock. First enemy aircraft inbound. Guys have started leveling off. I'm gonna just bring the boost pressure back to 12 pounds. 9,000 feet. Lead Spitfire's over there. Second one is there. Enemy aircraft was slightly higher than me underneath that cloud at my 1 o'clock position. Climbing here. Right, I'm now going to angle off to the right, try and sandwich that incoming between us. It also means I'll be climbing perpendicular to him. So if he wants to try and get on my six, he's going to have to turn and climb at the last minute. He's going to wash off some energy in the process. So try and put the enemy off my left. Right, he's now there. He's still climbing quite rapidly. I've just kind of pushed the throttle forward quite some. Looks like they're climbing over the safety of their base for the minute, rather than coming towards us. How to trim, just get stable. Get balanced, rather. Yep, they're staying over their base. They're not coming at us down... they're not coming straight at us and meeting us halfway. They're going to force us to try and meet them over their field. Okay, I'm going to now go for the 180 miles per hour climb. It's pretty close to test climb speed. And we'll put the guns on the fire position. Take them off the safe position. Always good to remember to do that. Okay, we're just getting a little unbalanced there as the speed washes off. 180, we just need to lower the nose to try and get back to that 180 mile per hour climb. Supercharger height. That is very welcome, supercharger. Gives me a massive kick in the boot, in the booty of boost pressure. The enemy aircraft's just a little bit above me now, off my left. The left trim required there, left rudder trim. Okay, I'm going to reduce everything. Just to get my temperatures down. I won't lose much climb rate from there. Still got 2,000 foot per minute. He's now closing on my 9 to 10 o'clock position up there. Looks like he's heading straight towards me. Okay, now I'm going to try and extend away from that using some airspeed. And if he's going to dive on me, he's going to have to dive and glide, well, shallow dive down onto my position. Now we'll go up. I want to just try and extend away from him a little bit, see if he attacks me or if he attacks the other aircraft off to his right. And if he doesn't attack either, then I'll turn towards him. Just above that cloud. Still got a very high nose up attitude. Okay, I think he's decided to turn. And I've got a dogfight over there. He's going left, he's going towards the coast. So now I'm in probably quite a good position here because I think he's heading towards the coast. 20,000 feet. Yep, he's heading away. Decided not to go aggressive on me. That's a very interesting. Right, that's good. Basically skipped past him. He'll be back, I'm sure. He's probably watching this fight over here with some interest. And he'll be one of these guys who drops in on this fight. Now we can head over as the aircraft would hopefully. Sorry, I'm just adjusting my track IR a little bit. Hopefully now we've got some altitude on this flight and we can go in. See what damage we can do here. Still got eyes on him and he's way off above that cloud. He's probably at 26,000 feet. Doesn't bother me. Optics in these clouds. Still up here. It says at 30,000 feet now. Up there, 12 o'clock. Okay, just pick the other airspace around here. That's good. Okay, that guy, oh, he's still way, way up there. Oh, hello, he's turned back. Okay, he's actually closing on me now. See him again. Yep. He's up there and he's turned back towards me. Just gonna see what this guy is. I think this could be a Spitfire. Yeah, that's a Spitfire. Okay, we've got two Spitfires over here. Just gonna give this guy. And we've got the hostile way up there behind us. Looks like he's having a good look at us too. Just gonna give the Spitfire a wing waggle. He looks like he's interested in me. Okay, now he's turning back. And the hostile is contrailing behind us. You can now see he's drawing a big white line across the sky up there. It's fine. He can draw that white line. Very conspicuous up there. And I'll be up there soon too, and I'll be just as conspicuous. The alternative is just to drop down way below and avoid him entirely. But we've come this far now. Someone's swinging around behind me. I think it's that Spit. Or is it? Is now turning back in towards me, I think. So I'm just going to force him ish over in this direction. Here he comes. He's got a good lick of speed on because he's in a descent. He may be heading away from me. It's hard to tell the angle. He really is going for some high patrolling. Go for a bit more up here. Twenty-six now for us. Don't think we're going to contrail until we hit 30,000 feet, which is where he is. Miles per hour in the climb, which is fine. I want to force him to keep turning, changing his heading. He wants to try and close with me. He has just descended a fraction. I think he's sort of descending, climbing, descending. He's a lot higher than me though. Ooh, ooh, ooh. This will be an interesting engagement. So he's probably got 2,000 to 3,000 feet on me. I'm going to gain some of that rapidly here, but I can't afford to put the nose up. This will stall. But I want to keep him above me, and I want to keep him at contrail height. This makes it so... Here we go. He's now become a larger dot, so I'm going to swing back behind him. I want him to turn full 180 degrees in order to engage me. And it looks like he's going aggressive now. Yep, he's going aggressive. He's about to come up over the top. my 3 o'clock. He's just getting a look at me to see what I am, and then as soon as he works out that I'm a spit, he's gonna get real aggressive. Okay, let's go for a bit of airspeed. I'm gonna pop it back just to reduce a bit of drag, and hopefully we can gain some extra airspeed up at this high altitude. The air's really thin. Come on, mate, drop in, drop in, drop in. Oh, he's not taking the bait. He hasn't taken the bait. Very interesting flying. Either he hasn't seen me, or he's just calculating what he's going to do. Maybe he wants me to turn on him, which I'm not going to do. I will just start turning around, though. I don't want to turn too steep. Hello, he's descending. Here he comes. He's seen my contrail now. He's descending behind me. That's it. Keep descending. Keep descending. Good. I want him to descend. That little bit of a height advantage he's got on top of me, I want him to give that up. And he can make a level chase out of this fight. If I can extend in the level chase, okay, let's just see what a bit of RPM does to my airspeed. Yes, it does come up. Okay, we can go with a higher RPM. We do just gain a fraction of airspeed. Now what's he doing? He's turning off me. He's climbing. 31,000 feet. Almost level now. Keep climbing, girl. Come on. Doesn't need to be that much. It's 2,000 feet per minute. Just fine. That's it. Okay, I better just give the oxygen up here. Maybe the oxygen's on all the time. I actually don't know where the oxygen switch is, to be honest. Oxygen. I think that was it there. Just lost a little bit of airmanship there as I was looking down and adjusting. Okay, he's trying to close now. I think he's closing on me. Yeah, he is closing on me. I mean, hoping he's just a little bit happy about that. Want to make a mistake. He's actually closing quite rapidly. Go for the shallowest of climbs. 500 feet per minute. Oh, just descending there. Very hard to maintain this really shallow climber. Trying to take advantage of the large wing area. Because if I climb steep, he'll probably overhaul me. If I climb really shallow, I need to be able to see him now, so I'm just going to kick off to the right. But if I climb shallow, then I'm hoping my wings will do the work. That's it. Come here, buddy. Still coming. It's closing. Might be climbing just a bit too steep here. Hopefully he won't see this change of direction because of the contrails. And he'll confuse him a little bit. Nah, that didn't confuse him at all. He's now closing quite rapidly. We'll be within gun range in a second. So let's go and turn. Turn as tight as I can though without... Oh, Did it go up? Not really. And up a little bit. It did gain some height on me. Quite some way back now. I think I gained a bit of distance on him then. And left, it's an easier way to turn normally. Okay, very gentle, hardly any. Right, how much did he turn, I wonder? Go up quite some way. Let's see if I can gain some height here. Oh, got slow. I got very slow. And now I'm above him. I want to force him to have to overturn here. Well, there's two of them. What's this one here? It's another Spitfire. Okay, two on one. Right, we'll try the climb again, because I actually got good climb last time I did this. Okay, now the speed's come down, I've got to get level. Right, he's got the other spit on his six. I'm going to try and drag him and bag him now. I want him to fall onto my six. I want to drag him underneath that other Spitfire. I want him to follow me down here. I'm going to be the bait. The other Spitfire is going to be the hook for the fisherman, for the line. And see if he follows me down. This is exactly what we want. I want to be below Spit number two. That's it, mate. Follow me down, follow me down. He's not doing it. Oh, he knows he's got six. He's a smart fellow. So the Spitfire is the lower one of the two, and that 109 is sitting right on top of him. It actually looks like that Spit is just managing to out-climb. Focke Wolf, just, yeah, he's actually got faster. He's faster than the Focke Wolf, and he's climbing. And actually, here comes the Wolf. He's going to drop down on that other Spit. Okay, we need right rudder. Oh, this is a really fun fight. I'm enjoying this. I know it's not probably not very action-packed for a third perspective, but this is really cool. Okay, what I actually want to do now, I want to get behind him before he closes. I want to end up kind of like crossing the T in naval warfare. I want to end up behind his six. Anyway, I don't want to get the angle off, so if I give it away too early, but I'm actually angling back behind him, then he'll turn away. But if he realizes it too late, there, now it's fine. Now he's got a choice. He can either turn left or right, and he's going to go forward and up. Okay, fine. If he wants to catch me, he's going to have to now turn back. So I'm on his six. So he's got now two Spitfires on his six. And the lead one is closing pretty rapidly. Yeah, that's why he suddenly went defensive. And that's probably the end of the fight. Yep, he's not going to come back up. Yep, he's going to stay in the down position for now. So there we go. He has decided that he cannot stay up here. Once I got on a six, he just had no choice, really. He's now got to try and make it home. I'm going to drop. No, it's too fast, too fast. Come back up. Gentle, 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 gentle. Nice and gentle. Rolling over the top now and looking behind and low. Okay, 12 o'clock, two contacts, three contacts now. So I'm going to go and have a look. Let's check if we've still got enough fuel. We did have, yep, enough for a little bit of a fight. We were running full boost the whole time we were up there. Got to keep an eye out for that guy, just in case he climbed back up. But I don't think he will have. I think he will have just put the nose down and tried to outrun that Spitfire. That may very well be the Spitfire heading back, having been outrun. And we're left with pretty much empty sky. He's doing something aggressive. What is it, buddy? It's descending. Pretty hard. Oh yeah, I've got a low contact. Down over the water. Just lost sight of him. And let's just check out what those guys were over there. Oh, there is still fighting going on over there. But I want to see what this contact down here was. There we go. This guy here, down there. That's a 109 or a 190. Okay, he's just going forest, check six. Back to the forest. There he is, halfway across the forest now. Going across the bridge. He's heading straight for our base. He's right down low, too. Okay, left rudder and chop the throttle. How's my airspeed? Okay. Too much rudder. There's two contacts down here. Let's see what this guy does. I hope he's not a friendly. Oop, rudder. Too much. How's that? Is it alright? A little bit more. Airspeed is well over 400, so I'm just going to level off. Now, what is he? He's a Spitfire. So I've gone and given up my altitude, and it's just a Spitfire. Okay, well, that's the end of that sortie. I'm not going to have the fuel to climb back up to 30,000 feet, so we're going to set up for a return. So what have we learned? Well, we've learned that you don't need to be shooting to have fun. That was a really nice engagement. And it's good to know that at those very high altitudes, handled very gently, you can stay with the Focke Wulf at least. There's quite a scrap developing back there. See, if I'd been flying around at 10,000 feet, I'd be in the middle of that scrap. But the dude that was up at 30 would have dropped on me and shot me down. So I've got two choices. I can try and go up above everybody and save my bacon, or I can drop down into the action and get shot down myself. Oh, it's so close, that fight, but I won't have the fuel. I've only got 20 G's left, 20 gallons. That other Spitfire is on finals, so we're going to settle ourselves down into an approach now as well. Let's see if we can hear the engine here. Flaps down, I think. Yeah, it's got flaps down. And the gear. Okay, flaps and gear are down. We'll set up now for our... Okay, I'm going to target halfway down this... that guy go clear, because it looks like he's just done a re-armory kill. A little flash. And we'll park over here on the grass. Okay, let's shut the engine down, shall we? Right, we're done. That was a very, very enjoyable flight. No shooting. Like I said, plenty of fun.